expecting the debut of The Edge very, very soon here in the WWF. Here comes James, your buddy.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, there's Fred.
May I introduce to you the Jackal.
Fred the Alpha Boy, oftentimes heard on the Howard Stern Show. I know our fans in Boston, where we'll be on Saturday, June 27th in the Fleet Center, are very familiar with Fred, Howard, and I guess even the Jackal.
Cut the music. Okay, Fred, this is your big opportunity. Ladies and gentlemen, from the Howard Stern Show, Fred the Elephant Boy. Go ahead. Don't be shy.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen,
give it to him, Fred.
Coming down the aisle, standing 7'1", 306 pounds, Kurrgan.
Hey, maybe we get Fred to come out here and do your thing with
me. Company him are Princess Luna.
That was Princess Luna.
Introduce a man who has opened his heart to me and opened the doors to freaks everywhere. Lee Jackal!
Well, how edifying was that, ladies and gentlemen? And look, a little group hug. There's such affection, there's such love in the room. I can feel it. It's in the air. You can cut it with a knife.
What a way
it's,
to spend
it's deep.
What a way to spend a Saturday night here.
It's getting deeper. Look at what?
That is a huge, huge man.
I have never seen anybody in person that big in my life. I've shook hands with Andre the Giant. I've been around Kurrgan and The Undertaker, all these guys. I've never seen a human being that big.
Kurrgan doesn't look to be in the outstanding congenial mood here on Saturday night either. Kevin Flynn has the unenviable task of taking on Kurrgan.
Ooh.
And Jack Dunn, the referee for this thing.
Oh, come on, Flynn. This guy's 6'5" and looks like about 250 pounds. Kurrgan makes him look like a little kid, and he looks like he's got an IQ of about 12.
Jack, oh my, what a clothesline there. Flynn being turned inside out by this huge individual. 7 feet tall, well over 300 pounds is the Jackal, or is Kurrgan, I should say.
Yeah, you don't, with this crew standing in front of you, JR, you don't know who you're talking about.
Folks, you got to wonder about questions that should be answered this Monday on Raw. What a sidewalk slam. You got to certainly be concerned about everybody's welfare with The Undertaker, James, on this rampage.
Well, I think there's some other mysteries to be solved. Did Steve Austin set Vince McMahon up? Did Vince McMahon set Steve Austin up? Did Paul Bearer set Steve Austin up? And what's Austin going to do about it? Who's he going to hold accountable? I think it's going to be real interesting to see who gets to who first on Monday night. Watch this move.
Certainly the next great pay-per-view in this business is going to be WWF's King of the Ring, Sunday, June 28th from the Igloo in Pittsburgh. It's 2 weeks away. The next WWF pay-per-view.
JR, this huge monster is standing right behind you, thank God, instead of me, but he's blocking out all our light.
Blocking out the sun, and look at Princess Luna. Much to the Jackal's delight, Princess Luna, what a demure, petite little lady she is.
Boy, I tell you, there's such love and benevolence from the Jackal to put this parade of human oddities together and give them a place to go where they can be nurtured and loved instead of shunned and ridiculed. I really think it's great of the Jackal. And also, he's keeping them off the streets where I don't have to deal with them.
Come on, go straight away by Kurrgan. We were talking about the King of the Ring a couple of weeks away on pay-per-view, Sunday, June 28th, and the fans in Pittsburgh, big foot there, right in the face, are really getting those tickets for the King of the Ring.
Wait a minute.
Going quickly in Pittsburgh.
Look at this. I think he's setting up for the paralyzer. He's got a new spring in that hand. He's just waiting for Flynn to get up so he can put him back down. Ooh.
Look at that huge hand, the claw. And this one is academic. Perhaps it was before it ever got started.
Here is your winner,
drastically outman in here by this monster at 7 feet tall, Kurrgan. And what a group hug they must have late at night here on Saturday.
And Luna being the only female, I'm sure she gets hugged a little extra. She looks just like a fairy princess tonight, doesn't she, JR?
Well, not really. Not really. Are you feeling all right?
She looks like a fairy tale. She's just looking pretty grim.
She just climbed on board Kurrgan.
Well, they like to stay together, do the parade of human oddities.
We've seen Crackhead Bob and Hank the Angry Drunken Dwarf, now the Elephant Boy, the world's largest man who still has no name.
Good to see you again, Fred. He don't need a name when he's that big. We'll talk to you later, Fred. Say hello to Kid Vicious for me.
We'll be right back.